fewer people are actually traveling to meetings and actually having sit-downs face-to-face. A lot of people are leveraging collaboration software from Microsoft Teams or Skype or Zoom or WebEx or any of those, and maybe some others I'm not even thinking of. Understanding what that traffic is doing to your network is really important, especially if you've got a mix of people working from within an office and working remotely. Understanding that breakdown is very, very critical to making sure you have a healthy infrastructure. And the best way and easiest way to find that is through NetFlow Traffic Analyzer. Let me show you how to set that up. We'll start on the NetFlow summary page. So go to My Dashboards, NetFlow, NTA Summary. If you're running a Cisco infrastructure, have NBAR2 enabled, and have a recent protocol pack, then there's a very good chance that stuff like Microsoft Teams will actually appear on this application list. So we can go ahead and scroll down to MS, and there's a bunch of Microsoft stuff, but no Teams. So if you don't see the application there, that's fine. We can build a custom application to still show this, whether or not you're using Cisco infrastructure or running NBAR2. So let me show you where that is. So first we're gonna go ahead and close our navigator, and then we're gonna go to NetFlow settings. And from the traffic analyzer settings, I'm actually gonna start by building an IP address group. So go to manage IP address groups. Before you go ahead and build an IP address group, you actually need to know, what IPs are gonna be in it. Thankfully, Microsoft, Cisco, Zoom, and most of the major collaboration providers actually publish a list. Mostly it's for firewalls, but we're gonna take advantage of having that list available so we can monitor the traffic. So once you have that list, you create a group and call it whatever you want and start putting in the IP addresses. Once you've entered all the IPs, you can go ahead and save it. And just for safety's sake, I'd probably go ahead and export out your list. So now we have the full list of IPs we're going to be using, but there's only a couple of ports that are actually going to communicate on this. So what we want to do is build a multi-port application in NetFlow Traffic Analyzer and bind them to these IP addresses. So for that, we're going to go back to NetFlow settings. We'll choose the application and ports. And we're going to go ahead and build one. So let's go ahead and build an application. I'm going to go ahead and call mine Microsoft Teams / Skype. It only uses ports 80, 443, and the range 3478 through 3481. Again, this was all on the Microsoft page with details about the IP addresses. The source will be any address, that's any address I'm monitoring, and the destination will be Microsoft Teams / Skype. And we can leave it as all protocols, so we capture both TCP and UDP traffic. And then we just add the application. Once we've added that application and it looks good, we can go ahead and submit that back to the database. Now that we've done that, if you actually go back to your NetFlow page, from the summary page, expand the Flow Navigator, go to Regular Applications, and select Microsoft Teams / Skype, and then just submit. You can see it's only a couple of quick steps to go ahead and build a custom IP group and then a custom application, and then be able to see that kind of traffic in your infrastructure going out to one of these collaboration tools.